Hello, my name is Fumika Moriya, and I'm a first-year doctoral student in the Department of Precision Engineering. Today, I'll give a presentation of my research about learning and memory at the level of the neural network. The title of my presentation is Newborn Neuron, a Key Player in Learning and Memory. Would you like to improve your learning skill memory? Why not? In everyday life, we learn and memorize anything with our brains. It's said that our brains consist of around 100 billion neurons, and all of those neurons are given birth when we are embryos. But even as adults, there are exceptional regions where newborn neurons can be produced. One of those regions is essential for learning and memory. Interestingly, people with cognitive impairments like Alzheimer's disease have abnormal increase or decrease in the number of newborn neurons. So newborn neurons must be key players in learning and memory. But we don't know the detailed contribution of newborn neurons to learning and memory yet. I'll be working on this problem at the network level of connections among neurons. Neurons can convey information by emitting electrical signals. Also, neurons can change the strength of their connection pathway to process information. And this change in connection is the basis of learning and memory. Actually, it's more easily for newborn neurons to emit signals and make the pathway strong. Imagine what it'd be like if curious and playful children join a room full of adults. Similarly, my PhD research asks, how do excitable newborn neurons change the mature neural network? So I analyze the change in the electrical activity of the mature neural network by adding newborn neurons. I give two different input patterns to the network, and I train the network to learn only one of them, the train pattern. Interestingly, the network with newborn neurons made the pathway strong to process information of not only train pattern, but also the untrained pattern. Newborn neurons change the processing of different inputs and decrease the ability to distinguish two different inputs. Sometimes you need to process similar inputs in the same way. For example, when you see an apple with a bite taken out of it, you can recognize it's an apple even though it's not complete. But sometimes you need to process different inputs separately, like you can distinguish a toy of apple and a real apple. For efficient learning and memory, it's very important to keep a good balance between overlapping similar inputs and distinguish different inputs. My findings indicate that the ratio of newborn neurons may relate to this balance. For further work, I will investigate the optimal ratio for efficient learning and memory. This work will be helpful not only to treat patients with cognitive impairments, but also to improve your learning skill and memory someday. Thank you.